Pleasant good morning, brothers and sisters, sisters and brothers. Welcome to another act of worship with the Pro-Cathedral and Parish of St. George with St. Barnabas. Our service of Matins we share this morning, and I pray indeed that we will all have a very good start to our day for Jesus. So let us prepare our hearts for worship. We turn to page 360, page 360. And we pray together the prayer, the morning prayer in the morning. This is another day, O Lord. I know not what it will bring forth, but make me ready, Lord, for whatever it may be. If I am to stand up, help me to stand bravely. If I am to sit still, help me to sit quietly. If I am to lie low, help me to do it patiently. And if I am to do nothing, let me do it listening still to you. Make these words more than words, and give me the Spirit of Jesus. We turn back now to page 32, page 32. And we recite the second to last sentence from the bottom of the page, the second to last, at the towards the bottom of the page. Through Jesus, let us continually offer up to God the sacrifice of praise, that is, the tribute of lips which acknowledge his name. Page 35. Blessed be the Lord our God, by whose grace we are yet alive. Blessed be his Son, Jesus Christ, by whose rising we are set free. Blessed be the Spirit of God, in whom is our hope and our joy. Father, we come together in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, to offer you our worship, praise and thanksgiving. To you belong all power and glory. You are the source of all goodness. Let our worship be a witness to your peace and saving power. Through your Spirit, may we ever rejoice in the abiding presence of our risen and ascended Lord. Amen. O come, let us sing out to the Lord. Let us shout in triumph to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his face with thanksgiving and cry out to him joyfully in psalms. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hands are the depths of the earth, and the peaks of the mountains are his also. The sea is his, and he made it. His hands molded dry land. Come. Let us worship and bow down and kneel before the Lord our Maker, for he himself is our God. We are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand. If only you would hear his voice today, for he comes to judge the earth. He shall judge the world with righteousness and the peoples with his truth. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Lord, we pray to you for the forgiveness of our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone, and so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Set us free, O God, from the bondage of our sins, and give us the liberty of that abundant life, which you have made known to us in your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Our psalm or psalms for this morning are Psalms 5 and 6. Psalms 5 and 6, page 474. Give ear to my words, O Lord. Consider my meditation. Hearken to my cry for help, my King and my God. For I make my prayer to you. In the morning, Lord, you hear my voice. Early in the morning, I make my appeal and watch for you. For you are not a God who takes pleasure in wickedness, and evil cannot dwell with you. Braggarts cannot stand in your sight. You hate all those who work wickedness. You destroy those who speak lies. The bloodthirsty and deceitful, O Lord, you abhor. But as for me, through the greatness of your mercy, I will go into your house. I will bow down toward your holy temple in awe of you. Lead me, O Lord, in your righteousness, because of those who lie in wait for me. Make your way straight before me. For there is no truth in their mouth. There is destruction in their heart. Their throat is an open grave. They flatter with their tongue. Declare them guilty, O God. Let them fall because of their schemes. Because of their many transgressions, cast them out. For they have rebelled against you. But all who take refuge in you will be glad. They will sing out their joy forever. You will shelter them, so that those who love your name may exult in you. For you, O Lord, will bless the righteous. You will defend them with your favor as with a shield. Lord, do not rebuke me in your anger. Do not punish me in your wrath. Have pity on me, Lord, for I am weak. Heal me, Lord, for my bones are racked. My spirit shakes with terror. How long, O Lord, how long? Turn, O Lord, and deliver me. Save me for your mercy's sake. For in death no one remembers you. And who will give you thanks in the grave? I grow weary because of my groaning. Every night I drench my bed and flood my couch with tears. My eyes are wasted with grief and worn away because of all my enemies. Depart from me, all evildoers. For the Lord has heard the sound of my weeping. The Lord has heard my supplication. The Lord accepts my prayer. All my enemies shall be confounded and quake with fear. They shall turn back and suddenly be put to shame. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. And now we have our first reading from the book of Jonah, Jonah chapter 1, reading verses 1 through 17a. Jonah chapter 1, reading verses 1 through 17a. Now, the word of the Lord came to Jonah, son of Amittai, saying, "Go at once to Nineveh, that great city, and cry out against it, for their wickedness has come before me." But Jonah set out to flee to Tarshish from the presence of the Lord. He went down to Joppa and found a ship going to Tarshish. So he paid his fare and went on board to go with them to Tarshish, away from the presence of the Lord. But the Lord hurled a great wind upon the sea, and such a mighty storm came upon the sea that the ship threatened to break up. Then the mariners were afraid, and each cried to his God. They threw the cargo that was in the ship into the sea to lighten it for them. Jonah, meanwhile, had gone down into the hold of the ship and had laid down and was fast asleep. The captain came and said to him, "What are you doing sound asleep? Get up, call on your God. Perhaps the God will spare us a thought so that we do not perish." The sailors said to one another, "Come, let us cast lots, so that we may know on whose account this calamity has come upon us." So they cast lots, and the lot fell on Jonah. Then they said to him, "Tell us why this calamity has come upon us. What is your occupation? Where do you come from? What is your country? And of what people are you?" "I am a Hebrew," he replied. "I worship the Lord, the God of heaven, who made the sea and the dry land." Then the men were even more afraid and said to him, "What is this that you have done?" For the men knew that he was fleeing from the presence of the Lord, because he had told them so. Then they said to him, "What shall we do to you, that the sea may quieten down for us?" For the sea was growing more and more tempestuous. He said to them, "Pick me up and throw me into the sea. Then the sea will quieten down for you. For I know it is because of me that this great storm has come upon you." Nevertheless, the men rowed hard to bring the ship back to land, but they could not, for the sea grew more and more stormy against them. Then they cried out to the Lord, "Please, O Lord, we pray, do not let us perish on account of this man's life. Do not make us guilty of innocent blood. For you, O Lord, have done as it pleased you." So they picked Jonah up and threw him into the sea. And the sea ceased from its raging. Then the men feared the Lord even more, and they offered a sacrifice to the Lord and made vows. But the Lord provided a large fish to swallow up Jonah. But the Lord provided a large fish to swallow up Jonah. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The hymn number 545, 545. Eternal Father, strong to save. Number 545. 545. Now we have our second reading from the book of Luke, Luke chapter 8, reading from verse 40 to 56, 40 to the end. Luke chapter 8, verse 40 to the end. Now, when Jesus returned, the crowd welcomed him, for they were all waiting for him. Just then, there came a man named Jairus, a leader of the synagogue. He fell at Jesus' feet and begged him to come to his house, for he had an only daughter, about 12 years old, who was dying. As he went, the crowds pressed in on him. Now, there was a woman who had been suffering from hemorrhages for 12 years, and though she had spent all she had on physicians, no one could cure her. She came up behind him and touched the fringe of his clothes, and immediately her hemorrhage stopped. Then Jesus asked, "Who touched me?" When all denied it, Peter said, "Master, the crowds surround you and press in on you." But Jesus said, "Someone touched me, for I noticed that power had gone out from me." When the woman saw that she could not remain hidden, she came trembling and falling down before him, she declared, in the presence of all the people while she had touched him, and how she had been immediately healed. He said to her, "Daughter, your faith has made you well. Go in peace." While he was still speaking, someone came from the leader's house to say, "Your daughter is dead. Do not trouble the teacher any longer." When Jesus heard this, he replied, "Do not fear, only believe, and she will be saved." When he came to the house, he did not allow anyone to enter with him, except Peter, John, and James, and the child's father and mother. They were all weeping and wailing for her. But he said, "Do not weep, for she is not dead, but sleeping." And they laughed at him, knowing that she was dead. But he took her by the hand and called out, "Child, get up." Her spirit returned, and she got up at once. Then he directed them to give her something to eat. Her parents were astounded, but he ordered them to tell no one what had happened. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. On page 440, the Benedictus. Blessed are you, Lord, the God of Israel. You have come to your people and set them free. You have raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of your servant David. Through your holy prophets, you promised of old to save us from our enemies, from the hands of all that hate us, to show mercy to our forebears, and to remember your holy covenant. This was the oath you swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship you without fear, holy and righteous before you all the days of our life. And you, child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give God's people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins. In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine upon those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. It is amazing that even though we know of the awesome presence, the omnipresence of God, that we still try to hide from him. Jonah was instructed to go to Nineveh to prophesy, to proclaim God's word and will. And Jonah, as the scripture phrases it, chose rather to run away from God's presence, as if there is some place on earth we could go where we could actually hide from God. So I believe it is a familiar story, and I would be preempting the readings for the next few mornings, but nevertheless, we pretty much know the story of Jonah in the belly of the whale, and then eventually being set free and going on to Nineveh, and the people repenting. Jonah did not want to go to Nineveh because Jonah was convinced the people did not deserve God's love and God's mercy. He preferred to know that God would exercise his wrath upon them, just clean them up, lick them out, as we would say. And so Jonah rather chose to run away. But, well, obviously, we cannot escape God's presence. And so Jonah learned that in a very meaningful way. Later on, we are told about him sitting on the bush. The bush dries up, and the heat of the sun he experiences, and he complains. But when we come to the second reading this morning about Jesus, we see such a contrast as the leader of the synagogue, Jairus, is seeking God's presence. In the first reading, Jonah is running away from God's presence. He doesn't believe the people are deserving of it. In the second reading, we have a father seeking God's presence on behalf of his daughter. And so, as Jesus responds to the leader of the synagogue, even though his daughter gets to the point of death, she's raised up. And this morning, you know, we are reminded we cannot escape God's presence. So we should not even try. And as much as God's presence is always there for us, we should not take it for granted. So we should make every effort to seek God's presence in a very intentional manner. Don't just take it for granted that God is there for us, but be intentional about seeking God's presence, about wanting God, Almighty God, to be with us, about wanting to understand his will for our lives and seeking to fulfill it. And so this morning, as we are giving thanks for another day, and we will soon be leaving our homes, at least some of us or most of us, and as we step out into God's world, we are stepping out into God's presence and with God's presence. As we step out, we want to make it very intentional. Every situation, every circumstance, every meeting, every person, every individual we meet, whether they are Christians or not, let us seek God's presence in every situation, in every person. Let us try to discern where God is, what he's saying, how he's moving. And if we make ourselves so conscious today, I am very positive that we will have fresh insights as to God's awesomeness, God's purpose for our lives. So let us be intentional. And I think that's pretty much the word we would want to hold on to today, being intentional. God's presence is eternal, as we sang in that first hymn, Eternal Father Strong to Save. His presence is eternal, but it is a presence, one, we should not seek to run from it, hide from it, and two, we should not take it for granted. Be intentional about seeking God, learning and understanding his will and his purpose for our lives, and striving to accomplish and to fulfill his will and his purpose for us. So if we can do that today, I believe we'll be taking another beautiful step, a major step, closer to God, deeper into our relationship with him, and truly he will receive the glory. So we will not be Jonah today. No more Jonahs. I don't think we have any whales around at the moment. So let us do our best to be faithful to Almighty God, to be intentional in seeking him and giving him the glory always. Amen. So now we turn to page 42, and we recite the Apostles' Creed. Page 42. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Suffrage A. Lord, reveal your love among us, that we may know the joy of your salvation. Grant peace within and among all nations, and teach our leaders wisdom. Endow your church with faithfulness, and her servants with knowledge and true godliness. Defend, O Lord, the rights of the poor and the oppressed, that your justice may be known among all people. Lord, renew your spirit within us, that in us and through us your will may be done. Our collect on page 179, the last collect on that page, proper 23. We pray our collect together. Lord, we pray that your grace may always precede and follow us, that we may continually be given to good works through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. On page 45, we pray together the second prayer, Lord God, Almighty and Everlasting Father, you have brought us in safety to this new day. Preserve us with your mighty power, that we may not fall into sin, nor be overcome by adversity. And in all we do, direct us to the fulfilling of your purpose, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And now, sisters and brothers, as we take time out to thank God for his unending mercies, today we want to lift up in prayer all who are sick, those in hospital, those who are sick at home, and those who have to travel or preparing to travel in order to receive medical attention. We pray for those who especially need to travel but are having difficulties because of borders that are closed and air travel that is so limited at the moment. We pray for God's healing hand upon them and in their lives. This morning we pray for all those listed in our church bulletin, those who are sick. Remember to pray also for those others who have asked for the prayers of the church. We pray for them. I pray this morning for those in the hospital. Pray for Teacher Hazel. Pray for Del Rosa. Remember Bob. And any others who have asked for our prayers. Remember to lift up those unknown to us, those who suffer silently and quietly. And Lord, we pray this morning, wherever they may be, we pray that they would know that there is someone who cares, and that if they would only step out in faith and reach out, that there is someone who will respond. At the same time, Lord, we pray for ourselves, that you would touch our hearts and minds and stir us, that we may recognize those who have not been around, those who have been absent, that as we miss them, we would seek them out of genuine love and care and concern. We ask that you would point us in their direction and help us this day, that we would be able to bring your love, your presence into the lives of someone who needs to hear from God. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. In our prayers this morning, we are also remembering all those affected by the COVID pandemic. We are praying continuously for our doctors and all frontline workers, And we continue to give God thanks for their work, for their service, for their sacrifice. We pray, Lord, for our world, as the news we're hearing is pointing more and more to an increase, a rise in numbers of infected persons. And Lord, there are so many countries that are now struggling once again with the decision as to whether or not they need to close down their economies. Lord, we know it's never an easy decision for our national leaders, but we pray that you'd grant them grace, you'd grant them more of your love in their hearts, and that in spite of how difficult things may be from an economic standpoint, that human life must always come first. And so, Lord, we pray especially for the countries of Europe, the U.S., and certain states within the U.S. where the numbers are on the rise, more and more people. Pray for our Caribbean countries where their numbers in some countries seems to be growing as well. Pray for our brothers and sisters in the Bahamas. Pray for Bishop Lloyd and spouse as they have been asked to quarantine. From what we learn and understand, they have been exposed and not infected, but they've been exposed and so asked to quarantine. We pray for them. Remember our brothers and sisters in the Bahamas as well, where the numbers seem to be slowly on the increase. Pray for our sisters and brothers in Jamaica, in Trinidad, and any other of our islands where numbers are on the increase. Pray for our leaders to take sound and wise actions, and that our people, as citizens and residents, we may follow instructions, that we would play our part in striving to ensure that as we practice and follow the protocols, we are not only taking care of ourselves, but we are taking care of our brothers and sisters as well. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Let us also remember to lift up those who this day are celebrating, whether a birthday or anniversary. And we want to pray especially for our brother and sister, Earl and Kathleen Osborne, as they would have celebrated 70 years of marriage, 70 years of marriage. Yesterday, we thank God for sparing their lives and for bringing them this far on their journey. Pray for him to continue to surround them, fill their home and bless your home with his love and his presence. And we thank God that they can be a witness, a model, an example for so many of us. Love does conquer all. So we thank God for them. We pray for any others, any other couples who may be celebrating at this time during the course of this week. And for all who celebrate a birthday, we give God thanks and praise for another year of life for you, and pray that indeed your joy will be multiplied. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We take a look now at our prayer list for any prayer requests. We are remembering, of course, our sisters and brothers and all others who grieve and mourn at this time over the death of their loved ones. So we continue to pray for Sister Pearline Elms and family, Sister Joycelyn and family of the late Cuthbert Brown. Okay, we don't have birthday prayers and blessings to Emily Saunders. Okay, we wish her very best. Okay, on her birthday, and pray that God would indeed grant her a special blessing. Okay, rough birthday greetings there.
Okay. So, sisters and brothers, let us indeed pray for God's presence to be felt and recognized throughout our world today. Let us pray that those of us who are aware of this presence, we will make no efforts to run from it, but we would intentionally seek God, and that we would seek to make God known to others and encourage them to turn to Him. Okay. We also ask to pray for Adela Mead and Jean Lawrence. Okay, not sure if that's a celebration or illness, but we lift them up and pray whatever their circumstances may be, that God's hand will indeed be with them. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And so, brothers and sisters, we turn now to our prayer book, page 47, the prayer of dedication. Almighty God, we thank you for the gift of your holy word. May it be a lantern to our feet, a light to our paths, and a strength to our lives. Take us and use us to love and serve all persons in the power of the Holy Spirit and in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. May the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And now we sing our closing hymn, number 535, 535. Okay. Oh. Okay, so Adela and Jean are sick in hospital at this time. Okay, so we pray for God's healing mercies upon them and pray that they would have a speedy recovery and a wholesome recovery. Okay, so we turn to our hymn books, number 535, O For a Heart to Praise My God. Thank you. apologies. Touched that accidentally.
Oh, for our heart to praise, my God, a heart from sin set free, a heart that sprinkled with the blood so freely shed for me. So that is the heart that all of us have this day. That is the heart we go forth into the world with this day. A heart to praise our God. So thank you for sharing this morning, and I trust and pray that we will all have a wonderful day, a blessed day, and we will strive to be a blessing to some other. The Lord be with you and also with you. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. May his divine assistance be with us always, and may the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace, and at the appointed time, we pray they will rise in glory. Amen. Amen. Thank you for sharing. A blessed day to all.